Welcome back ke Adventure.
Please subscribe and hit the notification channel. We start with process costing. First, we compare job order and process costing according to the similarities. Both systems are used to compute product costs. Actually, when we are using costing systems, our ultimate goal is to compute product costs so that we can have the appropriate pricing technique or pricing method. And then also, they both assign material, labor, and overhead costs to products. Both uses the manufacturing overhead, raw material, work in process, and finished goods accounts also in the journal entries and T accounts. And finally, the flow of costs are basically the same. We move on to the differences between job order and process costing. First difference, process costing is only used for single product produced continuously, whereas job order, different jobs or unique products. Next, process costing accumulate costs by department, whereas job order accumulate costs by each job. So as a result, process costing compute unit cost by department, and then job order compute unit cost by job. Now I'm going to explain what is a processing department. A processing department is any unit in an organization where materials, labor, or overhead are added to the product. For example, there can be a mixing department, finishing department, and a packaging department in the making of cake products. All of the resources that will be spent in these departments will be accounted for using the process costing technique. Ayon, so dumako naman tayo sa flow of cost. Paano ba tumadaan ang mga gastusin sa mga accounts? As usual, meron tayong direct material, direct labor, and overhead. Upon processing, these resources or assets will be transferred or declassified into the work in process account, such that when they will be completed, they will again be reclassified into the finished goods account. At syempre, pag mabenta mo na yan, transfer na rin sa cost of goods sold. Ganun lang kadali ang flow of cost. We can review yung direct material, direct labor, overhead. Upon processing naman yan, mareclassify sa work in process. Pag natapos na, sa finished goods. Pag nabenta mo, reclassify again to cost of goods sold. And of course, you will collect your money and the cycle will be repeated again and again. Basta makolekta mo yung pera mo, ha? Gagawa ka naman ulit ng product hanggang sa mabenta mo, makuha mo ulit yung pera mo, at syempre, yaman ka na. Ganun lang yun, tol. So, specifically, kapag job order costing yan, ina-accumulate po natin yung direct material, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead to each job. So, each cost are being traced and applied to individual jobs, such that when these are being finished, pupunta na po yan sa finished goods kapag nabenta na sa cost of goods sold. Punta naman po tayo sa process costing. Tatlo pa rin klase ng gastusin, direct material, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. Ang difference lang po ngayon sa process costing ay hindi job kundi processing department. Pag natapos, punta rin siya sa cost of goods sold pag nabenta na. So, basically the same lang, ha? Pero yung nagkaiba, jobs dito sa job order, samantalang dito sa process costing, processing department. Ganon-ganon lang, oh. Tapos na niya ang introduction sa process costing. Yahoo!
Kung meron po kayong suggestions or comments, just put it in the link below. See ya!